What's going on, guys? It's me, JG, and welcome to some NASCAR Heat Evolution. I've been playing this game ever since it came out. I personally find it fun, and today we're gonna start a new series on it. So today, as you can already see, this is leading to a spoiler of who I'm gonna pick for my championship season. But we're gonna go with Lyndon Castle championship season regulation. Let's go. Yes, I want Lyndon Castle. And as you see, we have two paint schemes for Castle for number 38. Nice. but yeah, for the days on the 500, we're going to be using the fresh. Why was I going to say fresh from Florida? Florida Lottery. I keep getting my sponsors mixed up. We're going to use the Florida Lottery machine. And then, like, other races we're gonna use the Snap Fitness for. Hopefully they bring in more schemes, so they bring in, you know, more of his schemes. As we look at the race setting, so we're running at a 98% here because I'm not that great here. We're gonna run two times, you know, tire and fuel on a 13% race. Hopefully we get to some pit stops, you know. We're gonna have black flags and cautions on. We're gonna accept that. If we back out here real quick as we listen to this music. I actually like the music in this a lot. A lot. So we're gonna do the full damage. We're gonna do the real qualifying here. So yeah, full damage, quick qualifying. If we go to advanced, I'm on it on simulation and automatic. I am on the controller. So if you see me not holding my line that well, I am on controller, but I wanted to wait until I was a decent, you know, so I had a good feeling on this game, I guess. So, yeah, so here we go, we're just gonna hop into, this stays on the 500, I can't rap, this beat is hot, and you know that. Oh, I'm embarrassing myself. Clothing screens are quick as fuck now. Oh. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I just did that. I mean, but yeah, as you can see, the clothing times are just so fast here. So let's go ahead, get here and qualify. I have Bobby Labonte as my spotter. I don't have the Rick Allen pack. I do have DLC, so you will see some, you know, some of the DLC cars here and there. Like, at Auto Club or Fontana, if you want to call, you're going to be seeing your car, Elvis driving that subway car. You know, things like that. But anyway, here we are qualifying at Daytona. Now, Daytona qualifying is weird. Well, not real, but strict play qualifying is kind of weird. So what you want to do, you want to use this high lane for the first two laps to just round the car up. Just make sure it just gets round up nice and smooth here. I gotta make sure I don't hit the wall, because remember, full damage is on. You see right there, just the back end just wants to slide out right there. Talking about hitting the wall, that's gonna mess up my qualifying extremely. So the views I'm gonna be using, mostly, you're gonna see most of me, we only have three views if you already don't know, but the views I'm mostly gonna be using is either this or this. So the cockpit or outside. You might see me use the cam here every once in a while. But yeah. I like this game a lot. I just thought, hey, why not do a series on it? So here I am doing a series on it. So yeah, should be fun. Alright, so we're coming out of turn 4 to complete the first lap. We're gonna move down right here to hug this yellow line for the second lap. We get the car nice and round up. We're just gonna hug this yellow line here. Make sure we have a good line through the corners. Ooh. who touching that apron just rubbed all our speed off. That's not what we needed. We're not gonna have a great qualifying one here. Who knows, maybe I can save it here down the back stretch. Just gonna hug this yellow line. Start dead last. I usually suck at qualifying the restricted plates. Yeah, dead last. Alright, 40th. Hey, that's how we go. 4 seconds off the pole time by Eric Amarola, it looks like. So, yeah, we're just gonna go ahead, get up in here, and start the race. Alright, guys, so here we are for days on the 500. We're getting ready. Green flag is out for the 2016 days on the 500. Here we go. Can we get on the Ellis? No, we can't get on the Ellis. But we have a huge one right here. We just gotta use the draft to our advantage. Tony Stewart is back here with us. Let me pop this up. Come on, Ellis, I need you to go. That outside line is moving now, it looks like. Carlo, yeah, no, he wasn't there. Whoa, we hit a huge bump that got us all types of out of shape. I'm sorry there, Stuart. Oh. Oh my god. I got so loose right there. Thank you, Reddick, for letting me get back up. Getting loose again. Oh man. This is eventful. I do say so myself. But let's see. It's a, how many lap races? It's a 26 lap race. And we have 29 laps of fuel left. So we should not be able to make a pit stop here. I might have to turn this up to a times 3 difficulty type thing. But look at this. We just split Stewart and Reddick 3 wide. Huge one from onto Danica's back bumper. We have to check up just a bit. We slide up into the wall. Elbow pushed into there. We don't have any, we don't have any damage from that, so that's good. Debonetto, I have a huge one. Gonna go on top of Debonetto. We're trying to make our way through the pack. Oh, Danica and her Nature Bakery machine. Don't know what she was thinking. She must be eating too many brownies. But here we go. We're right behind Labonte. Outside lane is checking up just a tad. Gonna try to get grabbed that side draft. Inside lane is moving. We're stuck in the outside lane. If I can push Labonte, I can probably clear Debonetto. There we go. There we go. Oh, I'm not clear Debbie yet. Oh, man. That got crazy. That got real crazy real quick. We're behind Ellis here. Wide at 38th. Our goal is to try to win some races this season and make the chase. That's our goal. Let's see, 27 laps on fuel. We on lap 4 out of 26. We should not have to make or stop this race. Well, I guess it depends on all on our tire wear for this race. And if a caution comes out, I'm definitely gonna duck down and pit because we have a little bit of aero damage. Just a tad bit of aero damage. Because I scraped the wall there. But yeah, like I said, it's just minor. So if I do pit, I might likely just calm down, grab a splash, and repair the damage. Woo! Labonte's not giving me any room. Talented as hell. Being my spotter. And racing me hard on the racetrack. We're 3 wide here. With Annette and Danica, I believe. Oh, look, Casey Kane. Right here in 32nd. Eric Jones. We see our teammate up there, Chris Buescher, who's actually in the chase in real life. We are all on the back of Casey Kane. I'm trying to give him a push up to, who is that? AJ Allmendinger, but it wouldn't work. That's McCain's. Fortune knows on the Regan Smith. Let's get this inside lane going. Okay, the inside lane isn't gone. We're going to move to the outside. We have a huge head of steam. Just wanted this outside lane. If we could clear a cane, I'd be happy. Come on, we need to do this clear cane. It's not that hard. Casey Kane sucks. Sorry to all my Kane fans that watch, that's watching, but it's true. Alright, so we're gonna go down low on Regan Smith. Still behind Casey Kane. We're gonna use the draft for AJ Allmendinger as Casey Kane washed off the racetrack here. Huge run for Allmendinger. We're just gonna go right past him too.
All clear.
Just roll out the throttle just a bit. So we can just stay right behind Stenhouse. As you see, people are starting to want a single foul here. I think it might be possible for us just to get a top 20. Who knows? We're behind Stenhouse. Ooh, a little bit of contact with McDowell here. 20 laps to go here at Daytona International Speedway. Still there, McDowell is still there. The outside lane is not going anymore. Look at Brian Scott up there. We have to, the outside lane had to check up because of Brian Scott. Let me watch my attempts while I'm all on his bumper. Whew. I keep getting to the wrong menu. But yeah, we have a huge one. A huge one. On Allmendinger here. If we can clear him and somehow fit between him and McMurray, it's not gonna happen. Maybe in arcade physics, I could have made it happen. Or normal physics, I could have made it happen. But it's not gonna happen in simulation. We're behind the weekly caution right here. If you ever need a caution in a race, this is the guy you can count on, Brian Scott. We're trying to move a Florida Lottery Ford Fusion up through the pack. So far, we've made about 10 positions. We've made more, but we've just been falling back because I've been stuck on this outside line. Kane thinks he's going to get a run on me. Dies low. He's not going to do that. Nope. So we're going to go low right behind Regan Smith. We're going to try to get past Brian Scott here. Car washes up a little bit. That's because the tires are starting to fall off here. That makes the car at Daytona a lot more slippy. 18 laps to go here at Daytona. We're all over the back of this number 7 car right here, Regan Smith.
Still there?
Here we go. I'm just staying behind Smith. Oh, Smith moves up. We're going to go on the inside of him. We don't have any drafting help. We have the faintest draft from Stenhouse up there. If McDowell comes down, he's going to give us a ton of help. We're going to actually shoot high because we have a huge one. If we can get all the way up past McMurray. Oh no, I hit the wall. I think I might have knocked the engine out too. I did knock the engine out. Oh good, there's a caution. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take two cans, full field repair it, four tires, yes. So we're gonna do that. Man, I got too greedy there. That was all my fault. That was my fault. I got too greedy. Alright, so let's just go ahead. We're going to start 40th. Jimmy Johnson, Truex, and I'm going to roll up back here. If I saw so. A green flag is back in the air here at Daytona. I'm gonna go low past Truex. 14 laps to go here at Daytona. Can we get back up to, I think our high was 27th maybe? It's very hard to pass here. So, we're gonna try to do that. Inside lane has gone. Check outside lane is checking up. We're inside Devin Nettle and Kyle Larson at the same time. We have Dale Jr. and Chase Elliott up there. On that outside lane, we're just behind the bacon car, and it's actually making me hungry. I might have to go get something to eat after this race. Oh man, I love me some bacon. And we see Amarola's teammate up there, Brian Scott, checking up the inside lane back here, but the inside lane still has a huge one. We're under Chase Elliott. Now, my favorite driver used to be Jeff Gordon. That's why my channel used to be called JGFan2496.
Okay, yes, I have one.
You know. 13 laps to go. We're halfway through. I'm just playing with the throttle here. Just playing with the throttle here. We are just stuck where we are at. We are stuck. His NASCAR's most popular driver.
Still there.
Look at this. Scott is just holding everybody on this inside lane up. You see Stewart and Johnson jump to the high side to get around. Scott Amarola's going to stay with him because that's his teammate. If we can get by Eric Jones, that's... Whoa. Jones spun back there. And just killed our momentum as we get driven into. Feel bad for Truex back there because he got caught up in Jones's mess. No caution for that surprisingly. Now we're finna see if the AI starts rubber banding for us. Who knows? But yeah, like I was saying, my favorite driver is Jeff Gordon. Yeah, and ever since he retired last year, but he kind of semi came out of retirement. You know, to help Dale Jr. out with that whole 88 team, since Junior suffered from concussion, which I honestly feel bad for Junior and all the 88 crew guys and all those guys, but you know, they have Alex Bowman and they have Jeff Gordon filling in. But yeah, you just hate to see Junior. Praying for him, hope he gets, like, can't wait to see him come back in 2016. Who knows, maybe after this, since he missed like the second entirety, basically the second half of the season, he's probably gonna come back and win the entire goddamn probably win the championship in next year. Who knows? But anyway, as you see, we only got 11 laps to go. The rubber band and AI is taking full effect here. As we're just running up on these guys with a huge head of steam. Hi, Debonetto. Bye, Debonetto. What's up, Tony Stewart? I'm gonna have to check up hard because I have a huge one, and these guys are gonna go so very slow.
Still there. All clear.
Yeah, Brian Scott, you stay high. Oh man. So here we go. I'm gonna check up right about now. Just let the car roll to Jimmy.
Still there.
10 laps to go here at Daytona International Speedway. Can we at least salvage a top 25?
Still there.
Whoa. Larson literally almost made it 3 wide on us right there. With Elliott right there. I'm gonna shoot the middle. Oh my god, that worked. Whoa, that bump right there. There's a bump going to 3. Oh, me and Danica make slight contact.
Still there?
Come down, grab that side draft off of her again. But the outside lane is not gonna go anywhere. 9 left to go here at Daytona. Johnson's gonna drop down bottom. He said, I'm tired of this high lane. I'm a 6-time champion. What am I doing right back here at Daytona? Bob Labonte right here. Gonna try to move around Labonte. Ellis looks like he might have some damage, probably from that first caution. That probably could be what's holding up this. That was holding up this outside line. Yeah, you see he has. Well, no. It looks way worse from the back, from like way back than what it does right now. Oh, me and Almondigger made contact. I just had to save this race car.
Still there, Carlo.
8 laps to go here at Daytona International Speedway. What's going to happen?
Stay high. Still there.
Chris Buescher jumps up to the high lane.
Still there.
It actually killed me and Ellis' momentum. I'm going to go with my teammate Chris Buescher here. I'm going to give him a huge shot.
Still there.
Come on, front row.
Carlo.
Sorry, Chris. I'm gonna have to abandon you with three wide. Three wide in the middle. I had to abandon my teammate Chris Buescher right there. But it worked out. Tyler Reddick right there. Came down on me a little bit too much. Trying to grab that side draft. I have no help whatsoever. But I'm just side drafting the hell out of Reddick. And I'm just gonna skip by Reddick to come down in 25th position. Behind Amarola, who's fighting Mike Cornette. Past Mike Cornette. Up to 24th. If we can finish in the top 30 in this race, and then we can go out and win the race, we have a chase berth. So we're just gonna try to get by Amarola. We can't do it. Kenseth is slow because he wants to go to the bottom. Alright, here we go. We're driving. We're getting the draft from Regan Smith. 6 laps to go here at Daytona. Oh man, I had to check up. Again, pushing Smith. Amarola hasn't won. I had to block that. Door slamming. Door slamming McMurray there for a little bit. Paul Menard is up here. Can we get a top 20 finish here at Daytona? It would be big for our little team here in the number 38 machine. I'm reeling the fuck out this car. We're gonna make it 3 wide up top against Paul Menard because I have to run. It's getting risky. With only 5 laps to go here at Daytona, it's getting risky. Oh, Menard puts me in the wall, then Kenseth puts me on the wall again. Oh, I spin in front of the pack. We lost the engine again, so we're gonna have to pit again. Oh, this is gonna be good. Oh, Bob Labonte went 3 laps down. He has issues. But guys, with only a few laps to go in this race, we're gonna have to restart back in 39th. I get too greedy. Went on the outside of Paul Menard. Yeah. But look at this, Kevin Harvick is back here. Oh, look at the damage on Ellis. Look at the damage on... Oh, wow. Look at the damage on Ellis. Look at the damage on Danica. These guys are definitely going to be slow. But green flag is back out.
Hold your line.
2 laps to go here. We're in overtime here at Daytona. We have 2 laps to make as many positions as we can. We have to get past the damaged Ryan Ellis, though. His car is torn up. So is the 34. If we look at these guys are so damaged and so slow that it is holding up me and Harvick with the clean cars back here. Oh man. We're about to take the right flag here at Daytona. Oh man, the car gets so loose. So loose the car get. I just threw it all away there. White flag at Daytona. Not the day the 38 team on here. Not the day I'm on here. After having such a good run, I get too greedy. Get so loose coming off the corner there. It's like, oh. It's just gets so loose, that's all I can really say. It gets so loose. It's like we're gonna finish it with a 38th position here at Daytona. Not that bad when you think about it. Well, not. Well, it actually is kind of bad. But the day we had, I think we shown that this car has speed. It's hard to pass at Daytona. And with those damaged cars in front of us, I thought we were gonna be able to do a little something. But I was wrong. Chicken flag is in the air. I have no idea who won. But we're just gonna limp home this number 38 machine. But man.
We'll get him next time.
You will get him next time, just like Bob Labonte said. But yeah, guys. That was fun. That was fun. I love this game so much. That was fun. End up doing 28 laps. It looks like it's at the distance 26. Oh man. But yeah, we finished. Bob Levine's 21. Austin Dillon, the 3-car wins at Daytona. Wow. So Austin Dillon has won your Daytona 500. 3 for Dale right there. Winning. Kerber second. Breaks off to third. Blaney fifth. And Hamlin top 5. Blaney fifth. Right, Blaney fourth. Oh my god. I'm tired. I'm tired, guys. I just woke up. Yeah, I just woke up. Keselowski third. Okay. So anyway, guys. Whew. As you can see here, Austin Dillon for Chase Burff. Looks like Hemric, Kennedy, and Tiff are the 3 did not qualify for this race. So sucks for Hemric and Kennedy and Tiff as they did not qualify. Sucks for Bob Labonte. We was racing him in the top for like the top 25 position all year in the race, if I remember correctly. But it's like he had some troubles after probably the first caution because he finished about 7 laps down. I'm not completely sure. But yeah, that's gonna do it here from Daytona. I get the fastest lap. Look at Linda Castle looking all proud. I'm so happy. Keselowski led the most laps with 26, but he couldn't seal deals. Austin Dillon took away the victory for him. Casey Mears started 33rd, finished 8th. Great job from him. Kevin Harvick's the biggest loser here. Started 13th and finished 36th. Yeah. So that's going to do it here from Daytona. If you guys want to see more NASCAR Heat Evolution, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I will see you guys next time.